Kyrgyzstan is just, it's endless. You can't complain, right?
But it's gotta be some of the most beautiful mountains I've ever seen.
Skiing is a great bridge. Doesn't matter where you're from, what your background is, you can connect with people with vastly different religious beliefs, vastly different economic backgrounds, vastly different life stories.
It brings people together from all cultures, and we all love it in the same exact way.
Definitely in the last 20 years, the Middle East and Central Asia have been misunderstood because of a small group of people creating havoc for a much larger group of people who just want to get on with their daily lives and do the same things you and I want to do. For better or worse, sports are one of those things that link people together. And if we look out and see a champion from Kyrgyzstan, a lot of people in the United States are going to start thinking differently of the people in Kyrgyzstan. And I think it is something that the people of Kyrgyzstan and the competitors want, is to show the rest of the world that they're here, that they know how to ski, and that they're part of the international community. And that we just want to ski with them and see what they're all about.
When I was younger, I was lucky enough to have a pro skier actually come to my house and ski with me. And it was a guy, Dave Crichton, that I looked up to. So when he came to our house, man, that was just a mind-blowing experience, you know? To have him give us the time of day, talk with us, and just treat us like human beings, that changed my life, you know? And that really gave me inspiration into my own skiing, that I want to do that similar kind of thing and go to these spots that aren't often traveled by professional skiers, you know, and talk with the kids and get them stoked and let them know, you know, everybody's important.
We just jump with Ahmet Dadali! Man!
Ahmet is a great ambassador for skiing, and it's really clear it's not just about him, it's about making a great experience for the skiers in Kyrgyzstan, especially the younger kids. It's awesome that they get to see this professional skier who's Muslim like them, who's come to their town. He's not just saying, hey, look at me. He's saying, hey, show me around. That's incredible. It just breaks open the expectations for what's possible.
Good.
Yeah, was that good? Beautiful.
Hi, I got their acceptance, so I'll take that. Oh, yeah,
today we're out here with Timur. Brought him out here, man. He's killing it, having a good time. There's smiles on everybody's faces.
The awesome thing, you know, about streets is you don't have to have the best skis to be able to do it. You don't have to have money to get on the hill. You just find something in the city and you can set it up with some friends and hit it. So now I get to kind of spread a little bit of my street knowledge to Timur. You know, in the next couple of years, I'm gonna come back and we'll be hitting streets with a big crew of Kyrgyz skiers.
I just witnessed Ahmet doing a really cool jump off an old water tank down there. But since I've never really watched street skiing or urban or rural skiing until I met Ahmet. Maybe that was a rodeo. It looked like a cool jump, and he, I don't know, maybe it was like a double nug-nug or something. I have no idea.
Yeah, Stacy, he's an intimidating dude for the first time. He's this big football player-looking dude, ex-military. He doesn't exactly fit into the free skiing criteria. So meeting him, you're like, what is this guy about?
Welcome to Kyrgyzstan.
Ahmet and I are pretty different people. So I think on the outside, it's like, what the hell are these two guys doing together? But through skiing and both wanting to spread the stoke of the sport that has meant so much to both of us in our lives, both of us got to come to Kyrgyzstan at the same time because we want to expand the community of skiing. The Kyrgyz, they wanted to start a Kyrgyz Freeride Association no matter what, and they wanted to have a competition. We were invited in to help organize and hopefully elevate the competition. So he came over as our head judge for the competition and just to share his time and his skills and his expertise with folks here.
Never would I have thought I'd be all the way out in Kyrgyzstan, have mountains like this and have such a similar vibe in the ski world. You know, all of us are here for skiing. You're excited to ski, I'm excited to ski. We're like a family up here already.
Welcome to Kyrgyzstan Competition 2020!
The event went beyond any expectations that I had. We had 40 plus people sign up from 12 different countries for the inaugural Silk Road Freeride event, and that's awesome.
I'm Julia from Kazakhstan. We are here to ride, to participate in the freeride competitions. It took us 12 hours to get here by bus, but we made it here, so we are happy.
So we're about to get into some pretty deep pile for the competition, and I get to go first, so it should be fun.
When a guy like Ahmet shows up, what it says to the people of Kyrgyzstan is you matter. And I think that's what we're all looking for, right? We all want to believe that our lives matter. And Ahmet really showing up provides a sense of dignity and that people care about who they are.
Lesson out here for the first ever Silk Road Freeride event. It's a cool thing to be a part of right now.
They just have so much appreciation for this happening and being able to ski with each other, meet each other out here, coming from different countries. They got everybody coming to Kyrgyzstan to ski their mountains. Best moment of the event is seeing them cross the finish line for the first time with the big smiles on their face, rolling around, you know, leaning back. Well, that for me was like, this is exactly why I'm here. This is exactly what I want to be a part of. And this is exactly what I want to continue on. There was quite a few behind the scenes guys to help make it happen.
Maksat's the local legend. He has a lot of respect of the community, and he gives a tremendous amount of himself. He definitely makes sure that, at least within the ski community in Kyrgyzstan, there is a we are and not just an I am. And he's the reason this event was successful.
Spirit of the Silk Road for the ladies.
Having the opportunity to win a pair of new skis can be potentially life-changing for a skier here. There's not even a pair of skis you can get here that's brand new. That's only gonna serve as a motivation for younger folks to keep going in the mountains, to expand international tourism in a sustainable way, to grow skiing here, and to become a more equal player around the world.
If you're working your life away for these goals for yourself, you're not creating a better world behind you in a lot of instances. And what I see these guys do is just, it's creating a better world. It's bringing communities together. It's giving people a bright future. You're setting aside the life you know to be able to achieve these things. And I think that's hard. And when it works out, it is rewarding. And that's why they do it, you know? Because it does make a difference and they can feel that.
If you fly all the way to Kyrgyzstan, it takes 30 plus hours to get here. We didn't want to stick around just for 4 days. And it was amazing, Ahmet inviting some of the local skiers out with him to hang out and to show the places that they care about.
We are right now in the Tescalato range. We're up in the mountains, never not powder shedding.
We were invited by the Kyrgyz skiers to help out. That's a huge honor, you know? And they say, hey, we think you have something that can help benefit us, and we'd appreciate it if you bring it here. And I can't really say no to that, given my own background as a soldier in this region, to be able to give back versus take away, to be able to show up with open arms versus holding an M4.
When you get everybody on skis, man, it's just like a bonding moment between everybody. It doesn't matter what color you are, where you come from. It's just like a thing of beauty, and that's what's amazing about what we do and what this kind of event can pull together. With skiing, you know, my whole life was filled with opportunity. I've been given a lot, and people have helped me get there. So I believe I've been given these opportunities, and after seeing the way this all played out, I'm hoping to be able to help other people free ski and give those same opportunities that I was given.
20 years from now, I hope we can look back and see a series of 10 to 12 events that are world-class events from China all the way to Lebanon. Top riders, top athletes. And I think it's gonna be the tour that the top athletes in the world are gonna wanna participate on.
Hit it, dog. You almost caught air. Yeah.